إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل الله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما Verily, all praises belongs to Allah. We praise Him and we ask for His help and we ask for forgiveness and we ask for protection from our wickedness and from our bad deeds. Whosoever Allah guides is the truly guided one, and whosoever Allah misguides, no one can show him guidance. And I bear witness that no one has the right to worship except Allah. He alone, he has no partners. And I bear witness that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his servant and messenger. Our khutbah today is going to talk about the purpose of creation. Why are we created? Many people all over the world have different views on why they are being created. Some people don't even know why they are being created. Some people know why they are created, but they don't act upon it. So today, our khutbah today is going to talk about the purpose of creation. Some people thought, or they are thinking, that humans are just going to create it coincidentally. It just happened just like that. So when you ask them, when you die, where are you going to? Some people have to believe that yes, when they are being created, but when you die, you are going to come in another shape or another form, in form of animal. If you do good deeds in your first life, then maybe you come back as a bird. If you do bad deeds, you come back as a snake or something like that. But in Islam, humans and jinns are not being created but to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ We have not created man and jinn but rather than to worship. For you to know the real purpose of creation, someone really needs to go back to the main sources, which are the Quran and Hadith of our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When you believe in something and that thing doesn't have an effect on you, then that thing you believe in is not important. So as Muslim, if you believe you are a Muslim, it needs to show on you. It needs to show on your daily activities. It needs to show on each and everything you do that yes, this is a Muslim doing it. But how do you do that? Are you going to think about it? Or you are going to check from the Quran and from the Hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Example, as Muslims, we have been taught that whenever you meet your Muslim brother, you should wish him salam, wish him peace. When you see a Muslim brother, you say to him, Assalamu alaikum. Then, for him, he should greet you back more courteously. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. It shows you are Muslims. May peace be on you. And he's going to answer you, may it be on you too. But if you look at today all over the world, yeah, people have different ways of greeting each other. Good morning. Hi. What's up? If you analyze all these greetings, one after the other, you tend to conclude that the best of greeting is the greeting of Islam, which is Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. For example, when you see someone and greet him hi, and you ask them, what is the meaning of hi? No one can tell you the meaning of hi. Hi has a lot of meanings. Hi might mean something high, it's up, it's high. Or it can be a form of intoxication. If someone is being intoxicated, we say it is high. So if someone sees you, intoxicated, what's it intoxicated? It has no meaning. So when you say what's up, no matter how you try to give it a very good meaning, it doesn't have meaning. What's up? You look up, nothing up. But in Islam, if you are following the teachings of Islam, you say, Assalamu alaikum, may peace be on you. So as Muslims, we should know we have been created and we have a reason for being created, so we have to follow the teachings of Islam that we should say, Assalamu alaikum, may peace be on you. If the angels are around and they said Ameen, then peace is going to be on you. So we have to keep all other teachings that are not the teachings of Islam, and we should utilize the teaching of Islam. A life without a purpose, it's no life. For Muslims, when you wake up, you have the dua you do. When you are about to eat, you have the dua you do. Even when you forget in the middle of eating, without making the dua, you still have the dua you do at the middle of when you eat. When you finish eating, you say Alhamdulillah. When you are entering the masjid, you have the dua you do. When you are going out of the masjid, you have the dua you do. When you are entering the toilet, you have the one you do. And when you are coming out of the toilet, you have the dua you do. But other people elsewhere, all over the world, you just go in, you don't know how you go in, and you don't know how you come out. So as Muslims, we have to go back and learn our deen. And where do we learn this deen? From the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So as Muslims, we have to fear Allah wherever we are, whatever we do. We should know that we are being created for a purpose. Yes, we can read, we can study, but everything should be with good intention. You can come and study engineering and be an engineer, but for the sake of Allah, because the intention determines a lot of things. No matter how good your work is, without intention, it is not valid. So you can do a lot of things with good intention in Islam. Have a purpose. Why am I doing this? For the sake of Allah. Then inshallah you gain a reward in this dunya and in akhirah. There are some people, they are Muslims. They believe they are Muslims, but they are not practicing Islam. When you see their life, you tend to become, start thinking, are they Muslims? Their life has no relationship with Islam. The way they dress, the way they eat, the way they mingle with their friends, you don't even have Muslim companions. We need to change all these things. We need to have good manners as Muslims. Whenever someone sees you, he has said a Muslim. May Allah help us. Then, we should be aware that the purpose of this life, when we finish, we have to go to Akhirah. And in going to Akhirah, there are steps you have to follow. You don't just go to Akhirah just like that. Just because you want to go to Akhirah, you just don't know. Brothers and sisters, someone needs to die before going to Akhirah. And before you die, it's not the death that a Muslim should be afraid of. Because today, everyone, either a Muslim or a non-Muslim, whether you have seen it in the Quran or you've not seen it in the Quran, you believe you will one day die. So death is not even what you should be afraid of. So what are you going to meet when you go to Akhirah? That's for Muslims, we have to do a lot of good deeds, we have to do what Allah asks us to do, and we have to restrain from what Allah told us not to do. So what are you going to meet when you die? This is the question everyone should ask himself. What are the obstacles that people face when they are about to die? What happens if they are dying? What are they going to meet in the life of Barzakh? When you go to your grave, they will ask you a lot of questions. How are you going to answer them? Are you going to cram them here in this dunya and go there and say them? No. What's going to help you on that day is your iman and taqwa in this dunya. That's what's going to make everything easy for you in the day of Akhirah. So is it reflected in our lives today that we are sure tomorrow when we die in the life of Barzakh, we are going to answer those questions? Then after answering those questions, then we go to the day of judgment. How are you sure you are going to clear through that day? It is that day that nothing is going to work but two things: your good deeds and your bad deeds. So how often are we doing the good deeds? How often are we doing the good deeds? And how often are we refraining from the bad deeds? Because if you look at the world today, the people doing the good deeds have very, very minute number, but a lot of people. It seems like we've forgotten about the way the Jannah is and the way Jahannam is. That is why evil deeds have been prevailing every day. But you as a Muslim, you have to sit down and ponder upon what you've been doing. Some people, 3-4 days, they won't sit down and do istighfar for what they've done. As if they think they're not going to die. Because if you believe you are going to die one day, it's going to change your lifestyle. It's going to encourage you to do more good things. Will you call your father and say, "If you love and you will love me, you will love me"? Alhamdulillah. On the day of Qiyamah, when your good deeds are going to be brought in front of you, and your bad deeds, and your book is being given to you, and they will ask you to read your book, and you're going to see each and everything you've done in this dunya. No matter how minute your good deeds are, on that day you're going to see them. And no matter how minute and no matter how large your bad deeds are, you are going to see it on that day. That is why I encourage my brothers and sisters today, we are in the month of Sha'wan, a month that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you fast the month of Ramadan and follow it up with 6 fasting in the month of Sha'wan, you are going to be granted as if you fasted the whole year. This is a whole huge big thing. On that day, you are going to see it. But subhanAllah, brothers and sisters, some people will, some people will not. This is something that will not take anything out of you. The whole year, just 6 days. Just 6 days. But at the end of the day, the month will be over, and you see some people who have fasted 6 days of the month of Sha'wal. So I encourage and I pray, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the opportunity to fast the 6 days of Sha'wal. And the bad deeds, brothers and sisters, we try as much as we can, whenever you do any bad deed, to ask for forgiveness from your Lord, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Try as much as you can to avoid the sin. And if it happens, ask for forgiveness. Because on the day of judgment, nobody is going to ask you the sin of your brother, but your own sin. And you are going to account for it. On that day, each and every part of your body you use in making that sin is going to talk on that day. Your hand, you see, you use your hand, maybe it's your mouth, you see, you use your mouth, your eyes, you see, you use them, maybe such and such. So brothers and sisters, we need to increase our istighfar. Whenever you do something bad, you do istighfar. So that on the day of Qiyamah, when you open your book, you've done such and such, and you've done istighfar. You've done such and such, and you've done istighfar. But it is so unfortunate today that Muslims, even when they've committed the sin, no one has seen them, and they come out telling people the next day. Do you know what, brother? I did such and such. Yesterday, we went to the party. Happy. Mostly among students. Happy. Yesterday, we went to the party. We did such and such, we did such and such. Instead of you to go back to your room crying, asking for forgiveness, oh Allah, please forgive me. I've done such and such, which I'm not supposed to do. And Allah will forgive you. Do you know that on the day of judgment, there are some category of people that Allah is going to shield them away from other people. And Allah will ask them, "Ata'arifu dhanba kadha? Did you recall that sin you committed?" The servant will say, "Na'am, ya Rab. Na'am. Yes, my Lord. Yes. Did you recall?" Because for Allah to ask you, "Did you recall such and such thing?" is different from, "Why did you do such and such?" Because you can't give an answer. Here, there's an ease in the judgment. "Did you recall you did such and such?" You say, "Na'am, ya Rab." And "Why did you do such and such?" is something different if you are to give the answer. Because you can't give the answer. Because you can't cheat anyone over there. Say, "Na'am, ya Rab." The servant will say, "Yes, my Lord. Yes, my Lord. Yes, my Lord." And the servant is going to be terrified that, "Oh, it's over for me. Allah knows I've done everything." Then Allah will say to him on that day, I have concealed your sins in dunya. I am also going to conceal your sins in akhirah today. So this is your way to Jannah." So brothers and sisters, we've committed the sins and we are saying them out today. Do you think you are among category of people that Allah will say, "I've concealed your sins in dunya," after you've already opened them up yourself? Here's a question to ask. And you don't need to ask anyone but yourself. So brothers and sisters in Islam, we should try as much as we can to ask for forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should try as much as we can to live a life of purpose. We should have determination in whatever we are doing. Akhirah should be our target. Akhirah, whatsoever we do, akhirah should be our target. Doing good to your family, akhirah should be your target. Doing good to your children, akhirah should be your target. Even doing good to yourself, akhirah should be your target. Coming to school, akhirah should be your target. How do I finish school? Go back, help my fellow Muslim brothers wherever they are in this dunya. If you even can't help them, at least pray for them. That is why I always encourage people that we should pray for people that have been suffering in Gaza and Pakistan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them. We should pray for them. When people go on Facebook and write, "Save Gaza," it doesn't save them. Pray for them. Make a comment on Facebook, Twitter, everything, doesn't change anything. You pray every day, you make salah, you make sujood, that is where you should pray for them. That is where the love is. But telling people, writing it, doesn't change anything. The people doing it will not stop what they are doing. But Allah has no power than those people. At least tell your Lord, read the Quran. Make tawassul that, "Oh Allah, this Quran, if you know I read this Quran for yourself, oh Allah, make it easy for them." And you pray for them. That is just the sincerity you can show to them. Writing in English, it won't change anything. teaching them. So that is why I always encourage my Muslim brothers and sisters to always ask the Allah, Allahumma hasibni hisaban yasira. Allahumma hasibna hisaban yasira. This is the dua that each and every one of us should keep increasing, because hisaban yasira is this hisab I just told you, that Allah is going to shield you, make a barrier between you and the other people. Because each and every one of us here do sin. Allah will ask you, are you not doing that? Did you record the video? That is hisaban yasira. That is the simplest you can get. That is the simplest you can get. So that hisaban yasira is what all of us need. We need it, our family need it, Muslims all over the world. It's hisaban yasira we need. But are we working towards it? Are we praying for it? That's the question we should ask ourselves. You have to work for it. You can't just live your life the way you want to live your life and you start thinking, oh, if I'm about to die, I'm going to do kalima shahada. No. You have to live your life as a Muslim and pray. And you should be sincere with taqwa, with ikhlas. Then Allah will make it easy for you. May Allah make it easy for us. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He should make it easy for the people of Gaza. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us here and make all our work and day was fruitful for us. May Allah protect us from shaitan, from bad friends, from our shortcomings. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا وسلموا تسليما اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا ودعاءنا وركوعنا وسجودنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى والمغفرة اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين ورحمتك يا إسلام ويا رب العالمين أقيم الصلاة